and then we were late by 7 minutes. So if we have penalties, we're down to 4. If we don't have any penalties, we could be battling for second.
Okay. So it's all technicality at this point.
Yeah.
That left Clifford once again to pick up the cudgels for the team, and the man gave it a real go, turning the heat on the BR4s, right up to the chilly dawn of Sunday. But just when it was getting interesting, his transmission gave out on him. And that was it. Before even the final stage could be run, the VR4s had conquered another leg. Pip Isada had gotten himself another win, and Mandy Oduke another second place finish. It was obvious the Shell Mitsubishi Rally R team was way ahead now, sparing nothing to secure every single advantage for the VR4s, like a water-cooled suspension system that they tried out here. Talk about all-out support. This fancy bit of a contraption cost $5,000 a set.
Put in a new suspension for it. It's a water-cooled system.
The suspension?
Yeah, so we're just trying it. I think it will be better than what
something new.
If it was fancy suspensions for the VR4s in Batangas, it was straight-cut gear boxes for the Subic leg. A noisy piece of equipment, but if you ask Amos Hugh just what the doctor ordered for the kind of rally that was to take place here in Gordon Country.
Performance class. From junction, the performance tire.
And this is a fair start.
In swimming, the athlete has to cut through the water as cleanly as possible. Drag is eliminated by wearing swim caps or, as in the case of men, shave their heads just to gain precious seconds, spelling the difference between victory and defeat. And for the motorist, during the rainy season, make sure your tires have maximum road contact, even in wet conditions. Changshan tires are designed to cut through and channel water away from the contact area between road and tire. Computer design patterns assure your performance even in adverse conditions.
Well, it's what we call a straight cut. That means the teeth are straight instead of helical.
Which means
it uses less horsepower from the engine.
Oh,
so more horsepower is on the road.
It was going to be a first for rallying here in Subic. The first year for any motorsports for that matter since the Americans left. The first two since Mount Pinatubo covered this place with Lahar. And just how thick the Lahar was became clear right on the first three stages as the cars rolled through thick clouds of Mount Pinatubo dust that blanketed the mountain pathways and the jungle trails. This off-road portion of the Subic Rally was really just the opening part, but for difficulty, it may well be the whole rally itself. For one thing, the very first stage claimed an early victim, Clifford Chertesa, came on limping with another busted transmission. The jungle trails that awaited them in the next two stages were even worse. Some cars just falling by the narrow wayside like dead cattle. The rugged stage showed just how the equally rugged VR4s were in a class by themselves. The Audi Quattro travel brakes also had a good run. But it was the remaining Mazda that seemed hell-bent for leather. alone now. Mike Potenciano found himself pressing. But in the map dash for points, there was Paeng Nodalo in his two-wheel Toyota, challenging for third place. It was a challenge that was extended up to the tarmac stages. Good, well-paved asphalt tarmac that allowed the drivers to get the most out of their cars. And once again, the cars that got out the fastest were those with the mostest. The BR4s, once again, the noisy straight-cut gears and all, showed them to be in their elements. Isada had some tough moments. He found some corners just a little bit too sharp. But Isada is a mature driver. Not beyond grandstanding at times, but on the whole, stable and resolute, and almost unshakable once he had the lead. His part was the more daring, understandable at this point because he was behind and needed to take more than the usual risks to get back in the race. But trying too hard had its price. His Mazda could only take so much, and like Clifford earlier, his transmission gave out. And that cleared the way for another one to finish by the BR4s. Trouble Briggs, pleasantly surprised at bagging third, and Paeng Nodalo right next to fourth, but in clear command of the two-wheel class. And that set the stage for the Mabuhay Rally, the fourth and final leg of the 93 season, and fittingly, the longest and the toughest of them all. 3 days and 2 nights that would take the caravan on a 1,000-kilometer odyssey from Moles of Luzon. Starting near midnight in a quiet barangay in the Han Wadesia.
He's battling it out, no? For the driver of the year away.
You're kissing that type of goodbye, right?
Yeah, and we just want to squeeze in maybe into one of them. So a top two finish is what we're looking for.
It definitely looked hopeless for Mike to catch up. Mick was way ahead with a perfect 60 points after 3 legs. Mandia Duque in the other BR4 at 42 points was also looking secure in second place. With only 15 points, followed by Mike with 12. So far behind were the Mazdas that Mike had not even bothered to survey some of the stages. Makatapos lang was all he said he wanted.
There is but one name in motocross. In this process of all motorsports, where man and machine are pushed to the limits. Always, Kawasaki pulls through.
I'm the network patron Kawasaki. Malaking bagay. Kaya ang pupukan ng laban.
The technology applied here is the very same technology used in the street version of your Kawasaki. So, on the road or off it, get that Kawasaki advantage.
Take part in Nodalo's winning season. Join the Road Elitist Club. Get a discount card with a unique Nodalo's touch. You can even enjoy meals at selected hotels and restaurants, all with the same Nodalo's Road Elitist card, the winner's discount card.